Very distinguished colleagues, let me comment the mover of this motion, and let me state quickly that the fiscal federalism is at the heart of this motion. Mr. President, distinguished colleagues, Nigeria is one of the few countries that is richly blessed with minerals of all sorts, both solid and liquid. A study has shown that every state in Nigeria has mineral at commercial quantity. If we are able to adjust our fiscal regime in such a way that states can benefit from those deposits. What has happened, Mr. President, and why this challenge, is that the federal government has taken more than it can chew. Today, we are battling with oil theft in the Niger Delta, oil bunkering and all sorts. And if we cannot control that, which is limited to some part of Nigeria, you can imagine the challenge of trying to stop illegal mining all across Nigeria, because every part of Nigeria has mineral. And I believe that illegal mining is happening everywhere. So the only problem, therefore, is that the federal government needs to admit that it doesn't have the capacity or not, has not shown less interest in controlling this issue of illegal mining. And so what do we do? I think the best thing to do is to look at item 39 in the second schedule, part 1 of our constitution, which states that minerals is the exclusive preserve of the federal government. Because the federal government do not have capacity or have not shown interest in controlling this, and the state governments where these minerals are deposited have not shown interest because it's not their business. So the only thing we can do is to make sure that they have interest in these items. And the best way to do that is to give them interest in those minerals that are deposited in their states, as done in other federal states. So I think, therefore, that what we need to do in order to minimize this challenge is to take away minerals from the 39, which is the exclusive list, and take the concurrent list, so that the states will have a share of the exploit of the minerals in their various states, and then they can show sufficient interest where they have illegal mining. Even some states are even involved today in illegal mining. When I listened to my friend from Zamfara and saying that Zamfara is losing revenue, it occurs to me that it's not advantage his mind that the fact that even Zamfara is not entitled to the gold deposit in Zamfara state. Constitutionally speaking, the best they can do is to maybe get 13% of the derivation from this mineral. So for them to have interest in this, all of us need to fight and ensure that we are able to adjust our fiscal regime, our fiscal federalism, in such a way that states will be able to have interest in some of these things in well-defined areas under our concurrent list. With this, we have people who now show that this illegal mining can be controlled, and they can be controlled. Once the states have sufficient interest in the mineral in their states, I think they can show more than a personal interest in controlling the illegal mining. But in the interim, I think the federal government needs to do more to ensure that we stop this loss of revenue by the activities of illegal mining. So I believe that all of us working together in the present 9th Senate or 9th National Assembly, we can be able to deal with our fiscal federalism in such a way that we can stop illegal mining and be able to ensure that revenues coming from these resources can be well channeled into appropriate quarters for our development.
Senator Abba Patrick Morrow.